My name is Lauren Baigrie and I am a member of the Scottish Youth Parliament for Carers Trust Scotland. I have been researching and consulting with young carers all across Scotland on the lack of financial support available while in education and in employment. Young carers in full-time education do not qualify for carers allowance, which currently stands at £62.70 per week. This is less than job seekers. We commend the Scottish Government for seeing the issue with financial support and introducing the Young Carer Grant. However, this is a one-off payment and I am concerned about what young people are to do once this is spent. My consultations found that many feel financial support is insufficient and as a result, many young people over the age of 16 are trying to juggle education, a part-time job, while full-time caring responsibility. Financial support would allow these young people the means to put more time into their education. When young carers are faced between choosing between EMA and carers allowance often wins, as it's over double the amount of money previously provided. However, in order for them to be granted carers allowance, they have to leave education. This does not protect their right to education or uphold their right to protection from work. The current national minimum wage for under 18-year-olds is £4.20, but if you claim carers allowance and are paying the minimum of 35 hours per week to qualify, this works out at £1.79 per hour. In contrast, a care assistant working in Glasgow has an average hourly rate of £8.45. Numbers just don't seem to add up. We recommend considering a consistent level of financial support that is awarded because a young person is a young carer, not because of what the possible parental income is. We welcome the new Young Carer Grant, however, we also encourage MSPs to constantly develop and monitor it, as there's concern there will not be enough of an incentive for young people to remain in education until they're 18. While Carers Allowance and the Young Carer Grant have my full support, the Scottish Government are missing out a key group. Young adult carers aged 18 to 25 who are in full-time education, they have access to no financial support. Often these young people have left the family home and are living at their place of study like myself. Many often commute to and from the family home and where they live to help look after their loved ones. Even though they're not at home full-time anymore, their caring role doesn't stop. And SAS really covers living expenses. Because of this, we're required to work part-time jobs at university, like most students. However, working part-time, caring full-time, while at university full-time, doesn't leave any time for a young person to be a young person. By having financial support in addition to SAS, young carers would have more space to leave, enjoy their university years, and excel in education. The government say they're committed to allowing young people to continue on to further and higher education. Young carers can't do this if we need to choose between our next meal and getting the bus to school in the morning. Thank you.